Why, hello everybody. I haven't made anything since the last recording, but I did want to kind of explain some things before I started building. I sat down and kind of brainstormed the other day after I did the last video and thought to myself, what components am I going to need next? What do I have to build in order for all of my idea to work? And I broke it down into four main parts that I'm going to need to start out with. First is going to be our wind logic unit, then we have our block logic unit, then we have our strategy logic unit, and then we have our randomizer. And each of these four things relate to how we want the different difficulties of the NPC as well as other functions to it. So basically, what's going to happen is it's going to detect the lines that are being run through for both player and what the bot has already taken, our NPC. And then from there, it's going to detect the wind logic first, and if there's no conditions being spat out from that, it's going to send it along into the next one and the next one and so on. Overall, it might be like a second worth of delay, but that isn't too bad, because it'll make it seem a little more realistic in how it's placing stuff on the squares. It's not just going to be as soon as you hit X, there's an O on the screen. So I'm okay with that. But anyways, it goes from the win into the block next. And then, of course, if nothing comes out of that, it goes into our strategy. And then, of course, if nothing gets spat out of the strategy, meaning that there's no way to force a win or keep yourself from losing, it's just a tie game from that point on, it's just going to spit out a random variable. And each of these kind of relates to how we wanted to set up the bot in the first place. Like just the plain old randomizer, none of those other features would be necessary to do our easy bot. And then, of course, our intermediate bot would need the win block, but no strategy, as well as the randomizer, too. So that's why I'm breaking them up. I think it'd be a lot easier to build it that way. And even if I wasn't trying to do a bunch of different bot logic, breaking them up is probably the best way of handling all of this mess, because otherwise, it just becomes this massive, convoluted logic unit that's almost impossible to figure out. But anyways, I'm going to actually start with my win in block and possibly my randomizer. So that's what I'm aiming for in this video, because the strategy one is going to be really complicated and I actually have to sit here and make logic tables for it and everything. So just bear with me, guys, and after the cut, hopefully I'll have something built.
And I'm back. I decided to live stream the build, but because it was Christmas, no one was really available. I had like 10 people that hopped on versus like the 50 or 60 I normally get, but that's all right. Not a big deal. I ended up building this logic unit here, and basically what this is, depending on the input, is either that win or the block logic unit that I was talking about making. So basically, if I'm stuffing the player portion of what they've taken so far into this, it's going to output what the computer needs to put in order to block those moves. But if I put in our NPC's moves that it's already made, it's going to output what it needs to place in order to win the game. Now, this isn't totally done, since I do need a little bit of gate logic at the very end of this, which is all the way down there. But basically, what I need to have happen is I need to have a way to luck out what has already been taken, since I'm not including both player and NPC into this. I'd have to make a way to say that these variables have already been taken. That way, if it's saying that it needs to output right here, for instance, what if this has already been blocked in a different clock of this whole thing, like a different turn came up. See, we're putting player input in here, and this is going to be their NPC output. But let's say this already happened. It's still outputting that no matter what, so I need to make a controller that says that this has already happened and not to use this. And on the flip side, if we have like a double win scenario, it would be outputting two of these. I'd have to make a way for it to say, I'm going to use this one over that one, or that one over this one, and so on and so forth. So, just a few things I have to add to it at the very end, but not a huge deal. I'll worry about that later on. So, I essentially got two of the four parts I wanted done. I started tinkering around with the randomizer, but I had decided that after being up some 30-something hours that I had enough. I wasn't willing to think that crazily and come up with something completely new in Minecraft. And yeah, it is a little bit of something new. Let me try explaining what I have in mind for that. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oops. So each one of these values would represent a different display. See, there's 9 of them there, 3 by 3. And basically, what I wanted the randomizer to do, instead of being true random, I wanted it to be cycling through these bits, kind of in the background of all this mess. Like, you wouldn't know what it's doing. It'd be doing it the entire time, no matter what. And what it would be doing is be taking one input, and it would be taking that and moving it along this line on a clock. So that way you wouldn't know where it was at any point in the game, but when it was needed, it would always be on one of these states. Now, this is known as a shift register. I've made several of these with Crucial, and he's recorded a bunch of them, and so on and so forth, if you really need a good example and not a crappy mock-up that I'm doing right now. But what I wanted it to do was say that these blue ones were values on the display that had already been done. Like, say X or an O already took this position. When it was streaming, I wanted it to go from, say, here to here on the next clock cycle. It would notice that these ones are taken, and it would say, I don't need to go here, I need to go here. And it would continue along, it'd see another one, and it would hop over it. And then once it reached this end, it would circle back into itself like so. So that's the idea, but I didn't feel like wrapping my head around that with no sleep, and I was just like, okay, screw it, I'll do it later. And as soon as I did that, Fancy and Far, my buddy Toby, decided that he had an idea on how to make it work, and he's been playing with it since. He's got it mostly working, except for that front and end portion of it. It can't be turned off at the moment, so he's working on a workaround for that to make it completely work for the whole idea. But like I said, it's something new in Minecraft. It hasn't been done, and I honestly don't even think it's been done in real circuitry yet. So, just some silly idea I had on how to deal with this mess. But let me try explaining what all of this nightmare is doing, so that way it makes sense if you're trying to follow along. Basically, we have. Let me actually do it like this, I guess. We have our 9 different portions of the display. Now, to win, we've got both corners. Then, of course, we've got 1, 2, 3 horizontal and 3 vertical. So that makes a total of 8 different win scenarios. But when we're trying to detect it, we're only using 2 different points on, say, this 3-point line, because we want it to either block or win that game portion. So each one of these has 3 different variants. So this is 1 just for that line, that's 2, and then of course that's 3. So what this is doing is it's grabbing those 3 times 8, so 24 different combinations of 2. And then from there, it's detecting it onto a single line, and that single line is telling it which segment to use of the 9 that we have. But when I was setting this up, I used signs, but over the course of using the world edit wand, I managed to break the signs about 25 times, and after placing about a billion signs during my live stream, I was just like, okay, screw it, I can do this without signs because I know the order of all this stuff. So let me just explain the order I put it in so that it makes sense if you're trying to do this yourself. But regardless, if you're making it on your own, you should be able to put them in any order you want and reliably achieve the same goal here. But I did a top left, top center, top right, middle left, dead center, middle right, bottom left, bottom center, bottom right, and the outputs I did it the same way all the way across. So, stop raining, damn it. So that is that. I hope that makes sense. It's basically the same AND gate logic I'm using for a normal logic unit. So for right here, it's this top left and the top center. If they're both on, it should be spitting out the top right in order for it to block or win in this situation. So that's what it's doing. And then there's the other combinations of that where it's saying, top middle, top right, then it has to output top left, and so on and so forth. That's all it's doing all the way through this. So I did, the horizontals first, which is why you see it step up like this and step over to here. And then from there, I did the verticals, which are, every three, and every three, and every three. And then I did the crosses, which are just all over the place. So that's my logic of how I did it, but you can do it any way you want as long as it, spits out the same direction or same way. So this is going in here and it's coming out there. And the reason I did this was so that every single portion of this goes through the same amount of repeaters. So if it has to go through this repeater, it misses this one down here and just hits that last one. Or if it has to go all the way down here, it misses both those. So no matter what, it's got the same tick on the output. So that is all that mess. And I'm gonna need two of these, of course. I'm gonna need one that takes in the player input and one that takes in the NPC output. Or input, I should say, since it's being held in the memory at that point. And then, of course, I gotta build the controllers for all of this. What I wanted to do is I wanted to calculate all of my logic units all at the same time, but it's going to trigger one logic unit first, and then if it says that it can't use this one, it's going to use the next one over and the next one over, so that way it's low tick rate. That way I'm not waiting for it to go through all of this, a logic gate, all the next one, a logic gate, and then all of the final one, and then a logic gate if it needs to use the randomizer. That just seems a little over the top, especially when I want to try locking out certain one of these for different difficulty modes. So I basically want it to happen all at once. After the player puts in his input, it's going to happen all at once. I'm going to have it set to a certain amount of tick that it's going to need to get carried through to propagate through all of the logic units and the gate logic for it. And then from there, it's going to force the whole thing to output at that point. So it's always going to reliably give me one output where I want it on the display. And then it's going to take that and stuff it into the memory the same way it would stuff the player input into the memory and so on. That's the idea here, but I think this is enough for a video right here. So I'm going to cut it here. Let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.